Hola.
Tom, my friend. Welcome home. Please,
yeah.
Enjoy us.
All right, I'm coming here.
Your house, man.
I'm meeting up with Jaime Orendain. I got connected with him through one of my distributors. Glad to be
Welcome
here.
Welcome to our family house. This house belongs to us for more than 100 years.
He grew up in Tequila. He knows all about the region. I mean, this is where tequila came from.
This is our central patio.
This is different. This is different from
yes.
me. And that's the house. But now we're outside again.
Tequila, this is my town.
Yeah.
I have a lot of members here.
Okay.
You know, when I was a kid, with my mm-hmm. grandfather and my mm-hmm. grandmother.
Now, I see it's called Tequila. Is that where Tequila is here?
Yes. The name came for the city and then the liquid. You know, the reason the most important distilleries are in Tequila is because we have very good water. You
uh-huh.
know, the Tequila mountain used to be a volcano.
Mm-hmm.
And the water that we have here came on the ground. You
mm-hmm.
know, very good water, very high quality water.
It's kind of like moonshining.
Oh.
We got to have that good water. You know, we're always looking for the right spot.
We need the best water. That's
uh-huh.
the reason we're
uh-huh.
here. Yes. But directly in my family, since 1924, we start making tequila with our family name. Let me show you, please.
Okay.
This is Don Eduardo, my grandfather,
mm-hmm.
and Mercedes, my grandmother.
So your grandfather, he was the beginning of this business.
Yes, and he was my teacher. He told me, you want to be in this business, you have to learn every single step.
Everything.
You know? I'm the third generation,
uh-huh.
and I have four kids. And they know how to produce tequila
mm-hmm.
because I teach them.
Everything, you know? Just like your father taught you.
Yes, we have tequila in our blood.
Yeah, Jaime and I, we have a whole lot in common. He's a third generation distiller, just like I am. Was he illegal?
At the beginning, that was illegal, you know?
Uh-huh.
That was a vino mezcal before tequila.
Mm-hmm.
And then the people start talking about vino mezcal from tequila. And they say, it's better easy to say tequila.
The history of using the agave plant to produce alcohol dates back to at least 1000 BC to the ancient Olmecs, and later to the Aztecs, who fermented agave sap into a wine called pulque. During the Spanish invasion of the Aztec Empire in the early 1500s, the conquistadors ran out of brandy and began distilling the Aztec pulque into an early predecessor of tequila called mezcal. Popularity of the agave-based liquor grew through the 1500s. Then, in 1600, the first large-scale distillery, named Hacienda Cuisillos, was established in the town of Santiago de Tequila in what is now the state of Jalisco, Mexico. By 1893, the town was renamed Tequila, and the distinct mezcal de tequila made from the local blue agave became known simply as tequila. In 1994, the Mexican government made the mezcal tequila classification official, establishing two separate denominations of origin. Tequila, which is technically a type of mezcal, can only be produced from blue agave, while mezcal producers choose from about 30 of the more than 270 varieties of agave that grow in Mexico.
This is El Llano Distillery. Since 1900, belongs to my family.
Uh-huh. There are different techniques in distilling around the world. So if I can learn even a simple technique, maybe I can use that to better myself as a distiller. Maybe I can bring that back home and I can enhance my technique, and maybe I can make something special.
We dump the agave here in the patio and we put it in the oven. This is the break oven and we cook with the steam.
You know, he's got a 40-ton oven that used to steam the agave.
The stone over there, you see it? That's
yeah.
a volcano stone. We take that rocks and we put it there.
Is that really strong?
Strong, and they have a temperature control.
How long does this take?
40 hours.
Okay.
So it's cool, squeeze the agave and take the juice out from here.
I see.
So we got the juice,
yeah.
we send into these tanks, and we add the yeast, 6-day fermentation, natural fermentation,
6 days.
Open fermentation.
Uh-huh. I do open fermentation
yes,
too.
Yes, me too.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
You know, you have a lot of flavors, and
yeah.
you know, for the air.
Yeah,
and everything.
It's because of where it's made at.
Yes.
It goes into the flavor. There are a lot of similarities in making moonshine and making tequila. We make moonshine in different parts of the country, United States, and that region actually gives the taste profile to that product.
Fermentation is ready.
Mm-hmm.
We send into the distillation area. We have a double distillation. We have a puff still.
Oh, look at that.
In the first distillation, we get the Ordinario. We have a lot of oil.
Okay.
In the second distillation, we use the Ordinario, we heat it, we evaporate the alcohol, and then we get the tequila, 50.5% alcohol. But
okay.
we cut heads and tails. We get the heart of the distillation, the real flavor of the agave.
Just like moonshine.
Yes. Let me show you the warehouse, and I have a surprise for you.
You got a surprise?
Okay. Yes.
The more time I spend with Jaime, the more I respect him, and the more I like him, actually. Tequila's in his blood like moonshine is in my blood. Hey, I know when I find someone who is the real deal, and Jaime is the real deal.
This is a very special place. You know, we age in our tequila in this area.
I'm seeing.
In this section, we have the new batch of the barrels, and in this section, we have the very old barrels. All the barrels that we use came from Kentucky. We buy the used barrel for bourbon, and we bring it to here. But today, we want to do a very special thing. We're going to open this barrel.
Okay.
It's a very old barrel that we use, have more than 25 years. This is the last batch that we want to use in this barrel is going to be today. We're going to check the proof, and we're going to taste.
Hey, I'm excited. You know, Jaime's telling me we're going to pull out a sample of it, we're going to check the proof of it, and actually taste it.
And then we're going to take the tequila. Now, please.
Okay, I'm doing the same thing.
Oops.
Yeah, I lost $100 worth, didn't I? I'm gonna have to work a day to get back. Jaime takes the sample of tequila, and we're checking the proof of it.
And now we're gonna check the density and the temperature.
Okay.
And then we're gonna match in this book to see how many proof that we have in the tequila.
Okay.
This is the density that we use. And the temperature, put aside.
53.
And then temperature.
24.
53, and 24 temperature. So 51.5% alcohol.
103 proof then.
Yeah, 103 proof.
Yes. Because the temperature conversion.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. This chart that we're using explains what you need to do.
It's a little high, and before we're bottling, we have to add water.
Okay. Whether you need to raise the proof or lower the proof to get the correct number.
And you feel the aromas from the wood. You have vanilla.
I'm getting that bourbon smell.
Yeah. They came from the barrel.
It smells really good.
Yes. It tastes better.
I've been waiting all day for this.
And I'm very proud to drink tequila with you, Tim.
I'm proud to be here. It's an honor. Drinking tequila in tequila. It don't get no better than that. My whole reason I'm here, I want to know, how do you make tequila? You know, where does it come from?
All the agave that we have here is a blue agave. Okay. That's the right agave to make tequila. Uh-huh.
I don't know how far it goes or how many acres, but as far as I can see, all the way to the mountain, all I see is agave. When you plant this, they this big?
Yes, like this big.
Yeah, these ones, we actually planted them on May last year. Yeah, so it's only 1.5 years.
And you know, this is a young agave. We have to wait almost 7-8 years.
That's a long time.
It is.
In my world, we grow corn and boil in wheat and we distill it, but it's a 1 year thing. There's a lot of work involved here. Do you have to buy it from somewhere?
We take care of the small agaves, the baby agaves, the seeds, and we replant it. You see the small baby agaves over there?
I see it coming out. You know, it's like a sprout.
Yes, each agave gives us like 2 or 5 different baby agaves.
Some of these plants are producing little plants. When they get big enough, they pull this from the mother plant and transplant those to make more bigger plants. But how do you plant the whole field at the same time? You know, I'm thinking, did they plant it with a machine?
One by one, by hand.
One by one, by hand. I contract guys.
So they're going to plant it, and they're going to watch over it every year until they harvest it. And then they have to come and chop it and then take it to the distillery.
Remember, when you have a glass of tequila in your hand, 7 years ago, there is a lot of people around planted the agave. We call this the valley of the agave plantations.
The valley?
The valley. And there is the highlands in the south of Jalisco. They make a very good tequila
over
there. Is
this higher?
A little bit higher than this, yes. You want to try the best tequila, and you compare, you have to try both areas.
He recommends that I go to the highlands, which is a couple of hours away, to where the blue agave is grown in a different environment. And it also gives a different taste profile to the tequila. So, you know, I'm gonna get a taste of something else.
So we finished the agaves?
Yeah, it was a good educational trip. It's very special for my first time in Mexico. But just meeting with Jaime was a great honor.
It's time to bring it back because it's tequila time.
It's tequila time.
Anytime is a tequila time.
Okay, come on. Let's go.